everyone. Hello from this nice river, Somosumik in Cluj-Napoca, with a little bit of garbage over here but and a little bit of buildings over there. But there is a river, okay? There is a river and that's good. I scared off a pigeon. Okay, so today I would like to talk to you about dance and about three ways of using it to bring more joy and empowerment to your life. So the first one, I was at this African dance workshop and, you know, and in a way, like, I was doing my best to sort of, you know, mirror those moves that the facilitator was showing us. It was not really working too well. And I remember, like, telling to myself, you know what? It doesn't matter exactly how I do those moves. What matters in this moment is that I stop trying and I just give it my best right here, right now, to just express myself through my body. And that somehow shifted something in me in terms of, you know, just having this ability to switch my state from just trying and failing and, you know, into, okay, I can just fully commit to giving my best in this moment, regardless if I'm getting it right or wrong. And this is something that I feel I've gotten really the luck and the honor and the joy of exercising many times in Bali, and is something that, like, I just have this very clear image of, like, dancing but, like, in full animalistic kind of sort of spirit with people there. And every time I bring my mind back to that memory, it fills me with so much joy and so much empowerment, really. And that actually has to do with my second lesson, which is about, like, creating an anchor in dance. So in dance, it's I think scientifically proven, maybe some of my friends will start checking on me whether and how much is this true, but, like, that's what I've heard, that it's actually scientifically proven that through dance we get to really release a lot of pressure and get into a much more joyful and happy state. And one thing I've actually, a friend of mine recommended and told me, was that we can train ourselves to bring back those kinds of happy moments and happy states by creating a gesture with our hand. And basically, for example, in my case is, I don't know why, but it's like this. Just having maybe 10 days in which we do that gesture and we remember a very positive, happy moment. And in a way, what we do with this is that we train ourselves that every time we do this, this memory comes along and makes us feel good. This is something that I used, and I used dance with this, and it has been such an amazing thing because it has this power of bringing me back to a space of joy and openness. On request, like, just doing like that. And it's something I would definitely recommend you to do, regardless if it's with dance or with something else. And the last part of dance that I would like to share has to do with actually something related to the sort of dance I've been practicing a lot of, which is ecstatic dance, where it's kind of like you go to a place where there's actually a lot of people around, but you dance for yourself. There is no alcohol, no smoking, no talking, and no requirement to be dancing with anybody but yourself. And you can also choose to dance with other people, but not like, oh, I'm with this person here, so we have to do this dancing thing all night together. So you can switch around or just dance by yourself, do whatever feels right, and just tune into your body and your flow. And it's such an amazing practice. And one of the things that I have noticed that it has given me is this ability, actually, when I came back here, because I couldn't find enough dance as compared to Bali, where it was like every single day there is dance if you want it, and for sure you have to go at least twice a week. So here that has proven to be a little bit hard for me. And because of that, however, just this dancing thing started popping up in different other moments during my day. And a very strong example of this is actually I've started dancing while I'm walking. And in order for you to understand this, I am going in the middle of the park, people are all around, and I'm just moving like this as I walk. and then just enjoying and expressing with my body. And you know, in a way I was thinking in the beginning, like, I feel free doing it, but at the same time I was like, how is this impacting people around here? And I realized that, you know, they might think I'm crazy or something, but some of them maybe would see this as sort of an invitation to express a little bit more of themselves, to show a little bit more of who they are. And it's that confidence and it's that, you know, just flow and enjoyment, regardless of who's watching and who's around, that I feel has an amazing power to really shift also your expression in any other area of your life. So this would be my three lessons for today. So the first one is committing through to the present moment, through giving it your absolute very best in that moment when you're dancing and when you're doing other things too. The second one was about creating an anchor of joy by figuring out a specific hand gesture that you can repeat and bring yourself back to this empowerment moment of dance or something else you like. And the third one was about figuring out some way, maybe through dance, maybe through something else, in which you express yourself in public fully, unapologetically, as you are, in full confidence, so that you give people an invitation to do that as well. So thank you very much for tuning in, guys. Love you very much. Have an amazing day.